Hi, this is Jackson Ng, and I'm at a very nice resort called the Calvert Kuching. And in this resort, you can see very nice environment, very green. And this is one of my favorite places in Kuching. And whenever I'm free, I'll find time to come here to do my reflection, to do my reading, to do my thinking, and to do my planning. It's a very beautiful place. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to share with you the art of reading people. How do you read people? Well, actually, there are indicators for you to identify, for you to know. And when you meet people, you always can put them into 5 categories. I call them the art of reading people. The first people that you are going to read, you're going to meet is called the blesser. So normally I show the blesser. The blesser are the people who come into your life and bless you. Say you're driving and then halfway your car got punctured, the tire got punctured. So they come to you and they say, "Hi, I am uncle, can I help you? This guy just want to fix the tire," and then he will just disappear. Now this is a blesser. The person who come to the scene and help you with your punctured tire. It could be an employee that you hire, and because he is helping you in your organization is doing a better revenue, better performance and productivity. So it could be anyone who appear in your life and bless you and help you. Like recently, I met a man called Icon, and he comes to our company for TDT. And after TDT, he said, "Jackson, can I help you with how to rearrange and reorganize your office?" I said, "Well, Icon, if that makes you happy, why not?" So he has been helping me for many days to rearrange, reorganize, and to coordinate the whole logistic of the office. And he put the right things in the right place, like all my boxes of books he put in a bookstore, and he do labeling and he stack up the books nicely, and he also helped me to throw away a lot of rubbish. So this guy came to me to bless me. So can I become a blesser? Yes, I can also be a blesser to all my DDT students. I bless them, I help them, I become the person who bless them with a certification. Can you be a blesser? Yes. If you walk into any organization, you see a problem, you solve the problem, you're helping them to minimize, reduce the problems, you become a blesser in this case. So everybody can become a blesser, and everybody also will invite blessers in their life and also in their organization. So the finger number one is the blesser. Finger number two, I want to share with you finger number two. What does finger number two do? Well, finger number two is someone who say, "Don't do this, don't do that." It's like a teacher, it's a good teacher, always point at you and ask you, do the right thing, don't do the wrong thing. So the second person who comes to your life could be a teacher. This teacher, a category, could be a boss, could be a superior, could be a trainer, could be a consultant, could be a sister, could be your friend, who comes in and tell you where you do wrong and how you do correction from wrong to right. So this person, the role is a teacher. They come to your life to teach you something. And without their presence, you may not realize that you are in the wrong. You may not realize that you are in the, you are doing something very wrong. So this person come to your life to teach you something, and after you pick up the lesson, they will just disappear. They disappear from your life because you have learned the lesson. God sent these people to your life to teach you certain things. We call them the teacher, finger number two. Now, finger number three, although some of you may see this finger and you don't like it, you say, "Wow, what is this finger about?" Well, I say this finger is a finger that we don't like to see. This finger represents the people who are problematic. The people who are problematic also appear in your life. They come to your life and then they start complaining about others, they're complaining about, you know, the environment, the work, their life, they complain about their mother, their father, they complain about a lot of things. These are the problematic type. When they come to your life, you have to be aware and do not just buy their stories. Because sometimes they have accumulated a lot of stories all their life, and what they're good at is they become very rich in excuses. So these are the type we have to be very careful, because everything they say may not be true. But these people, they bring problems wherever they go. And these are the people who really need help, because they are the problematic. They can carry virus, which is also contagious. And you have to be very careful, because these people, where they go, their mouth will carry the virus. So these are the problematic. they come to you and they give you problems. Now, let me go to finger number four, which is this category. These are the people who come to your life and they are here to love you. They are here to love you, to care for you, to nurture you, to see you grow, to support you, to encourage you. This could be the people that you love at the end, your spouse, your wife, your husband. Yeah, it could be your close friends who come into your life to love you. They accept you for who you are. They accept you for your imperfection. They just accept you and love you for who you are. These are the people who love you and they want to give their best to you, to support you, to encourage and to see you grow. These are the people you must keep them. You must keep them because these are the people important to you. You must put them in your inner circle, the people who come and love you. I'm very blessed to have Elizabeth come into my life and she has been a blessing. She has been a nurturer in my life and she has been helping me to see areas that I don't see before. And because of her love, I become a better person. Yeah? Now let's talk about the last finger. The last finger is the people who are very small. They say, help me sir, help me sir. These people appear in your life like when you eat in a restaurant or kopitiam, you see the uncle push the trolley and uncle say, would you like to buy my fruits? Would you like to buy my veggie? Would you like to buy my kueh? So why this uncle come to you? It's because they need help. They need you to give them some money. When you see people, a beggar, come with a can and say, uncle, tolong, uncle. These are the people who actually begging for some help. So when you see finger number five, you can choose to ignore them, but if you bless them, you give some money, you buy their fruits, you buy their veggie, you buy their products, God is watching and God knows that because you do to the least and the less fortunate, God will bless you in return. So when less fortunate come to your life, they need your help, do not ignore them. It is a test. If you do good to these people who are in the less fortunate, you do charity, you donate some money, you help them, very quickly you can see that whatever you give will come back to you. It will return to you. And this is very important. A lot of people do not want to help the beggars, the less fortunate, the poor, yeah, the isolated. But this is your chance. When you see them around, they appear in your life, help them. God will return your favor. So five fingers, I want to recap. The blesser who come to your life to bless you, the teacher who come to your life to teach you, this person who come to your life and give you problems, and number four, the person who come to your life to love you, to nurture you, to support you, and last, who ask for help. They all appear in your life. Identify which one they belongs to, which category they belongs to, and treat them accordingly. This is Jackson. Thank you for watching my video. And I am going to share with you more about the other topic. Thank you for watching.